our class on in-depth study of the Gemara. We're investigating 3,300 years of history, and we are now we're in the tour. All these people here that write on the tour and later on the Shulchan Aruch are all about the same period of time. They're all contemporaries. Now, I don't know why historically, but anyway, they are very, very big people. But there was a, must have been a very good time and a very active time in Torah learning. And you see that they're all from Poland, except the tour himself lived more than 100 years before these commentaries, and he was way before. You see the Ger Sfard, right? 1492, so it's 150 years before. So, they are definitely great men, but it's just interesting to know how to note that they're all Ashkenazim. The tour has been was accepted, of course, as the Shulchan Aruch for everybody. And then when Yosef Cairo decided to bring it to another stage of completion, so we had a lot of people, of course, disagreeing with him, and not only on his interpretation of the Torah, but on the interpretation of Shulchan Aruch. And on that piece, we're going to be investigating that. It's going to be very exciting and very heavy. Okay, so let's just go here for a quick review, since we've been away for a while, doing wonderful things. Quick review, of course, we have Abaya. Who asks Rava that the two pesukim in the Torah seem to be contradictory? One says you have to give the best of your field when you damage someone. Another pasuk says you can give kesef even suban. So one seems to exclude the other one, and we had four, five answers really altogether. Depends how you count, and basically, the Gemara left us with Reb Papa and Reb Hun, Reb Yeshua, two late Amoraim, and Reb Huna, who was an early Amora, and they had, of course, different opinions on how to resolve this seeming contradiction between the two pesukim. So, Rabbeinu Tam is pasak in our Gemara like Reb Huna, that if you have all three items, you must give kesef and meitav first, and only if you don't have kesef and meitav can you give metaltolin. We saw Rashi, Rif, and the Rush. They all agree that the halacha is like Reb Papa. Rashi, of course, is not. Didn't write on this piece clearly the halacha, but the way he describes the Mishnah, for instance, which he usually likes to describe according to the halacha, is that Meitav is one of the alternatives. When you give land, you have to give the Meitav. There's other alternatives. So they, that means the Rif says clearly the halacha is like Reb Papa, and the Rosh follows him. They'll be arguing that Kesev and Subin and Meitav are all equal alternatives, like Reb Papa said. Reb Papa changed our perception. He said the Torah wants you to give money back, and anything that was closer to money you can give back. So Kesef, of course, is money itself, and Shavu Kesef is very good because you can translate your the movables that you got from the mazik into money very, very easily by finding a lot of customers, good market. And as far as Meitav is concerned, we can up the ante with Meitav, with Karkaran. Even though there's a few people around that might be potential buyers, we can up it by saying that you have to give your Meitav Sadehu. So that was Reb Papa, and that was the Rashi, the Rif, and the Rush. The Ramah that we read in the Nemuki Yosef had a triple hierarchy. He said that he also held like Red Papa, but he understood Red Papa to mean that money is supreme, even though Red Papa did not say it. But by his distinction that he made between Metaltalin and Metav, he said that call me Metav who, unequivocally. Why? Because if you don't sell it here, not. And how does he learn Metav? Well, Metav, the Torah, lowered the bar on the Mazik and said that's also acceptable by giving this interest, added interest by the few people around. But according to him, Metaltalin is better than Metav, and Kesev is even better than Metaltalin. So anything that's close to the Kesev is more in the demand of on the demand of the Mazik. We had Rambam. Now the Rambam is, it's hard to underestimate the influence of the Rambam, both in the area of Jewish thought and most importantly our area in Halacha. Here he seems to be like no one in the Gemara. That's why I left him floating here. He seems to be saying, if you read him simply, that you don't go to the Metav first, you first go to Metaltalin. And only if he doesn't have Metaltalin or not enough of Metaltalin to pay, so then you go to Metav. He doesn't talk about Kesev, and people will bring riots as we go on that he holds that Kesev is like Metaltalin. But the surprise is that he says you first go to Metaltalin and then Metav. Well, that's not how we understood Rav Huna, because he put Metaltalin after Metav. Rambam puts Metaltalin before Metav. It's not how we understood Rav Papa, according to Rif Rash and Rashi, that they were equal. And the only one who is he's similar to is the Ramah, who does put Metaltalin in front of Metav and goes a step further and puts Kesev in front of it too. So he does have a similarity with the Ramah, and some people will want to link him up to the Ramah, and some people will just want to reread him and put him back into the Rav Papa, because usually the Rambam follows the Rif. The Rif taught the Rimi Gash, and the Rambam's father learned from the Rimi Gash, so that would be his propensity. But in this case, he says an unusual halacha, so we're going to have to find out where he is located. That's why I left him floating. He could either be the Raman, Rav Papa. Some people want to put him even Rav Huna, we'll see later on. So that's going to be, as usual, a wild card, because he doesn't tell us where he gets his halacha from. He just summarizes all of the oral law and all of the Gaonic literature up to his period of time, and he summarizes it, and that's it. And it's the work of the later authorities to link him up with the Gemara, because he's not doing things on his own. But since he's learning the Gemara in a way which he didn't explain, we have to reconstruct that. Okay, now the last person we're going to discuss is the Tur. Now, the Tur, we said, is the, let's close these people up here just to make life a little simpler. Okay, let's see if we close these up just to make things a little simple. All right. Now, the Tur is very, very problematic. He seems to be quoting the Rambam. We'll go into his language. It seems to be a paraphrase of the language of the Rambam and an elaboration. But we have this machlokus between the Beis Yosef and Bach as to what he means. So the Bach wants to put him in the Tur with Rav Papa and explain the language that he's just. When he says you go to Metaltalin first, it means you don't listen to the Nizak when he says he wants Metaltalin, he doesn't, he wants Metav. simple, because the pasuk says Yashuv Filosubin. So you don't listen to the Nizak when he says, I want your Meitav. And that's the simple way that the Bach learns, and he puts the tour into Reb Papa, which is nice because then he'll also line up with the Riff and the Rush, who's his father. So it seems to be in a nice Masoretic line. The Beis Yosef is the surprise here. The Beis Yosef says that the tour has he's not like the Rush. He's taking his own track. He's imported a dinner. We do know that the Rush even spoke about in Malvin Lova, where the person who's trying to get the money back, the Malva, has a right to ask for Metaltalin over Meitav. And that's why he says he's looking at it in the eyes of the Nizak. The Nizak has a right to demand Metaltalin over Meitav because of this similarity to the case of Malvin Lova. But if he wants Metaltalin and not Meitav, so then he has to accept either Kesev or Subin. So this is a very interesting combination. It looks like it's, and he says, the Beis Yosef clearly, that this part is like Reb Papa. The fact that Metaltalin is equal to Kesev is like Reb Papa. And he says that the tour imported this preference for Metaltalin over Meitav from case of Balchov. That's what he says. Okay, so this is the setup. This tour is going to be very, very important because from him, the Beis Yosef is going to, of course, write the Shulchan Aruch. And if he's explaining the tour this way, and he's going to hold that lahalacha, so then a lot of people are going to disagree with him and say that you missed the boat. And this is not the explanation of the tour at all. So that's where we're holding in our chart. We've come to, what is that called, the 16th century? 1575, actually 1488, okay. And now we're going to have to understand the tour. And the tour is going to be very, very essential, as I said, because the halacha, for 100 and some odd years, I'm sure people wrote, but the people at least on that they bring on the tour are like 100 and some odd years after him. The tour is accepted as the Shulchan Aruch, and people understood him differently. So that's going to have, as we said, ramifications on how we continue the journey down to almost that present time. The last person we'll get to, I was just doing, is Rebbe Simbeltzer, who was in the last generation. He was Rosh Hashiva Beitz Chaim in Yerushalayim. Okay, but that's where we're holding. Okay, so let's get a review of the text itself. Okay. Go back to the tour. So basically we understand that the tour is either going to be a new explanation of the Pasak, or he's going to be just the simple, what we always thought of Reb Papa. But whatever he is, he's definitely going to be a controversial figure because of the people who explain him. So here it is. Here's some texts just to get us, again, oriented. The Rambam says here, Keshebeistin niskakan ligvos, hanizmitayamazik, govin minamatatlin tachila. Says it clearly, that when the Beistin is obliged to collect from the possessions of the mazik, it first collects from metaltalin. And only in lo hayu lo metaltalin klal, or shelo hayu metaltalin keneged kol nezek, then you go when Hashem min hakarka min hayafi she be nechse hamazik, from the best of the karka that he has. For kol zman shemotzu metaltalin, all the time you find metaltalin, afilu subin, Ainis Kakin Lakarka. So if you read the Rambam very simply, he looks like the din is that the Mazik has to give Kesev and Subin as a payment. And only if he doesn't have Kesev and Subin does he give Meitav. So that's an independent Shita. Okay. The only thing close to it is the Ramah. But the other people like the Rif and everyone else we saw held it. It's not Rav Papa, of course, so everything is equal, and it's definitely not Rav Huna, because Rav Huna puts Subin after Kesev and Meitav. So this is the excitement. Now we'll read the Torah. What does the Torah say? The Torah says, very similar language, Keshabayin Lahagvot Lenizak Nesko. When we come, who we come, probably the Beis Din, to collect damages for the Nizak. So then, Rohanim, Yesh the Mazik Metaltalin. The first thing we do is we check out, does the Mazik have Metaltalin? So if he does, Ein Yordan Lenechse Lamocha Karkasav. We don't go down to his property to sell his karka. Eli ten metaltalin. What do? We give the metaltalin. So if he has karka and metaltalin, we give the metaltalin. Vafilu, he adds to the Rambam, who doesn't speak about kesev, and so he spells out, Vafilu sheyesh lo kesev, even if the mazik has kesev, yochel shalma besubin. Even if the mazik has kesev, he can pay with Subin. So the Mazik, if he has Kesev or Subin, can pay, and there is no, the Beis Din has no right to collect from his Meitav Karka. Why is Kesev equal to Subin? Because the Kol Milei Demetaltlin Meitavu, he says. Kesev is equal to Subin because all things are good. You see? Well, I thought that Karka was also good because the people around will jump at the Meitav. So it seems that simply reading the Torah, he explains, no, Metavtlin is called good and it's equal to Kesev, and that's why you should take it first, and only if he doesn't have it, you go to the Meitav. And then he adds, Vishamano so kafi mashi ochel mochrom yad mikomo, which is what the Rush said also. You do a shuma, that means you evaluate how much the stuff is worth, and you take its present value off what the Mazik owns. That's it. You don't have to run around and sell it and find in all these strange places. Whatever you can get for right on the spot, that's what it's worth. So that's what the tour says. And then he continues. If the Mazik doesn't have metaltlin, then you go to the Yiddish Menachas, you go to his Meitav, Afilu, and Zibras, and he gives all sorts of different laws of Zibras and as we learned from the Machlokes of Rebbe Akiva. Okay. All right. So that's a simple reading. It seems that would be the simple reading of the Rambam. It would be the simple reading of the Torah. For a reason we have to. The Beis Yosef does not learn the Torah this way. I have to explain why, but he doesn't say. What does he say, Beis Yosef? Chain Kasav, this is the first din. I put this here. I'm not going to, because that's going to be his interpretation. Now, we spoke about it last time. Keshabayim lehagvot lenizak nisko, roonim yesh lemazik metaltalin. That's what we yordan. If he has metaltalin, the mazik ain't yordan. Lenechasav, limkor karkasav. We don't go into his property to sell it. Ela yiten metaltalin. Nope. He can give metaltalin. Okay. So the Beis Yosef says, Ken Kesuv HaRush, prepare a comma, the Baba Kama, the Inyan Priyas Balchov. So he's, the Rush, the Beis Yosef is presuming, I suppose, that the tour, is following in the, his footsteps of his father, and he says this din, that there's a precedent of Metaltelin over Karka, the tour wrote in reference to paying back a debt. In other words, the creditor is allowed to demand Metaltelin over Karka. That's what he said. And he even quotes him, Le'inyan Prialchov near release as the rush, I isle le lova metaltlin bekarka, the one who's paying back, he's remember like the Mazik, then kafinin le le mesab le metlin. We force him to give the metaltlin. Im chofetz behena malva yotem mikarka e. If the creditor wants the metaltlin more than the karka, then we force him. We say, yes, you have a right to demand that. And he says, Asvara the rush. Kaven de Zuze Yehiv, since the Malva gave money, so shakul kol mide de makriv le Zuze Tve. So then the Malva has a right to, I loaned you money. I didn't loan you metaltlin. So since I loaned you money, I have a right, well, I didn't loan you land either. But since I loaned you money, so then you can't get karka. Karka is not money. See, again, they're looking at karka as less than money. You see? Kaven de Zuzehi, but he says, why? He says, as far as now, why do I have that claim? Because I gave you money, I want money back. I'm not getting money back, I'm getting metaltelin. So look what he says. He says, Zuzei is metaltelin. He's making an equation. Very important things. We would say there's a distinction between Kesev and Metaltelin. Says the Rush, no. Metaltelin and Kesev are equal. Why? Why? Because of its convertibility. So it's so close to Kesev that it is Kesev. That's how the Rush learns. And therefore, you can demand it, Karka, which is further away from Kesev. Okay, so, but the only reason you can demand this is because you gave Kesef. So now the tour, according to the Beis Yosef, took this din, which the Rush spoke about exclusively in Baal Chov, right after our piece, we looked at it, and imported it to the din of Mazik, and said, look, just like the Malva over here can demand over Karka, so to the Nizak can demand Metaltelin over Karka. He has a right, if he wants. Power a little greater. All right, that's what he says. Now, he says, why did the tour bring this distinction that the person who's trying to get the money back can demand Metaltelin over Karka? Why did he bring it to Nezikin? Nezikin, Leprius Balchov. Because of his work, he was the one, the Torah said, look, the same svara should apply to both places. If Reb Papa, the Torah used the Lashon of Reb Papa to show that Kesev Metaltelin was equal to Kesev. So if Metaltelin is equal to Kesev, and you make this distinction in Balchov to say that both of them are better than Karka, and you're telling me that the Mal has an ability to take the Metaltelin first, so I'm going to apply that also to Nezikin. And the Nizak is allowed to demand Metaltelin over Karka. That's what he says the Peshat in the tour is. Okay? And he says, even though there's a dip between it, because the Rush said that only in Baal Chov, but he says that chilek was not mashma to the tour, and we never saw anyone clearly making such a distinction between the dinim of Malva and Karka when it comes Malva and excuse me and Nezikin. So we can use the same in Svara, move the information that we learned in the Malva case over. Okay, of course that's going to be a big bone of contention. All right? So that's basically his big chiddush, to give the Nizak power to demand metalton over Karka. Of course, he can accept Karka, but if he wants to, he can to metalton. He can say, "No, I want. I gave you money. I want it back." And he can say, "So we said a little svara, by the way, why there is a comparison, because we said there's two ways to learn. You can learn because you have a mafarish text, or you can learn because there is a logical connection between the two items, i.e., nesikin and malva. So we said a svara that in nesikin you're not replacing the item; you're just replacing money." So if you're replacing money, and that's what the Torah wants you to give back, according to Reb Papa, money, so then everything that's more than money, the Nizak has a right, just like he does in Balchov. Okay, that's a little svara we said to explain why the Torah would import this din to Nizikin. Okay, fine. And he says over here, even if the second din, that even if he has kesev, he can, with Subin there, the Beis Yosef says, well, that we learned from Reb Papa. So the fact that kesev is equal to metalin, even Subin, we learned from Reb Papa. But we take the svara from Balchov and move it into our case of Mezikin to say that Karka is less, and that the Nizak has the right to demand it. That's what he says. Okay. It's a big warm-up. We have to keep all the pieces in place. Okay, so then the next thing we did was the Bach, okay, the Beit Chadash. Who disagrees with the Beis Yosef in Peshat in the tour? Okay, and we did that together, I believe. And he says, Keshaboyin Lahagvot, that's the first thing. He says, Nir Rabbeinu Lomad Livsok Ach Mehi, the Perakama, the Baba Kama. Where did it say over there? Ramelei Abai, the Rabbo. Kasav Meitav Sadeyu, In, Midiachwin Alo, Vahaitana Yashav Rabashava Kesav Hil Subin, Vaasik Repapa, Varevun Bred Reshua, Kol Mile Meitavu, Dilo Mizdabin Hacham Mizdabin, Be Tuchta Chrisa, Levad Mi Ara, the Lay Save Lemi Meitav, Ki Hechi the Lichpot Saleas Vina, it's a quote, it's a paraphrase. Alma, he says, Metav Van Have Tve. Meitav mikarka v'fil subin. So he also has to show a case that we say that metaltalin here, even subin, is better than meitav. And he says this is all coming from Agamar and Reb Papa, which is also a surprise, because that's, I mean, we saw that the Ramah learns that way, so they're lining up with the Ramah. But that's what he's saying. He's saying when you learn Reb Papa, you're forced to the conclusion that Subin is greater than Meitav. Okay, Metaltalin, Afilus, Metaltalin, Habitve, Mi, Karka, Afilus, Subin. So now, what's Peshat, though, in there? Says the Bach, Va'afal Pisha Nizak Chofetz Yoter Bakarka, even though the Nizak wants Karka, Matzi omele mazik, the mazik can say to him, Ana yehivne lecha kedincha mimeitav, dahayna metaflon b'figel subin. What do you mean you want karka? I'm giving you meitav. I have a right to give you meitav. It's even better than karka. I have a right to give it to you. So you can't demand meitav. Okay? Ella, Hello, Metatlin. The only case where the Nizak has a right to Karka is if the Mazik doesn't have Metatlin. So then you make of Sadeu Dahainu Edis. Then you have to give Mate of Sadeu even Edis. Aval. Im ha Mazik Chovitz Liten Karka. What happens if the Mazik wants to give Karka? And the Nizak wants Metatlin. and the Nizak wants metaltolin. Ein ha-Nizak kol. This flies in the face of the Beis Yosef. He says, no way. If the Mazik wants to give karka and the Nizak wants to give metaltolin, then Nizak has no power to force him to get metaltolin. Elenosan lo edis shibakarka sab. He can, as long as he gives him edis, it's fine. As the pasuk says, mesa semetov karmi yishalem. And he says, this case that we're just speaking about, i.e., when Mazik wants to give metaltolin and Nizak wants, excuse me, when the Mazik wants to give karka and the Nizak demands metaltolin, and I'm telling you that the Mazik can give it to Nizak, doesn't mean he can't do anything. That wasn't written in the Shulchan Aruch. The Tur only wrote the case where the Mazik wants to give metaltolin and the Nizak warns karka. That's the only case that was written. But the opposite case, not so. We'll go into this a little more carefully because it's a little quick, but that's what he's saying. Okay. Umizeh lo kasav Rabbeinu klum. This case was not written clearly in the Tur. Why? It was Peshitta who, the Al-Korcho lo kasav Arash, because there's no way you can import what the Rush said about Balchov, that there's a, that the case here, the Malva, who is the analogous to the Nizak, has a preference. That never applied over here. That's helpful. Okay. Dal korcho lo kasav harash peperek based urbeinu la'ail besamach kuf aleph ela b'balchov the urbeinu turos balchov d'imchov it's a malva metatlin then ain't a lo b'yochel akofo likach mimeno karka. That case, if the Malva wants to give metaltolin, excuse me, the imchofetz hamalva metaltolin, the Malva who's trying to collect wants metaltolin, and the lova, the imchofetz malva but metaltolin ain halova yochel kofa likach mimenu karka. This that the Malva can say, I want metaltolin over karka, is only a din in Balchov. Why? Kevin d'zuzei yehiv. Of course, in Balchov, you apply this principle of, since he gave money, he has a right to get things which are closer to the money. But in Nezikin, he didn't give money, so he has no right to get money over over karka. V'hainu metatlon. The came the zuzi even v'hainu metatlon. Aval, b'nezikin, ein ha-nizak yochel l'kofo li'ten lo metatlon. But in the case of Nezikin, the Nizak has no power to force the Mazik to give him a metaltolin. He has to accept the karka. V'lo kasav Rabbeinu Elahech, and the Tur is only writing in the one case where the Mazik wants to give metaltolin and the Nizak wants karka, and he says, I demand karka because it says Metav Sadehu, and the Tur said, no, you have to take the metaltolin because it says Yashiv Afilu Subin. That's the only place that the Tur wrote. We're going to go over it. Don't worry about it. As, of course, is not, says the Bach, like what the Beis Yosef wrote, because he understood Divrei Rabbeinu, the Tur, that his kavana was to say that, no, we are kofin the Mazik to give metaltolin, because that's what the Nizak wants. And he says, v'holei, so this is not true. Ella, like I explained, that really the Mazik has the Yador al Yona, and also if you want some authorities, there is a Magid Mishnah who's a Rishon who says that in the Rambam. So here's a link to the Rambam. We'll look at that. Let's do a summary, okay? Because there's a lot of facts going down here, right? Okay. Now, we have a case in the Tur that gives a preference of metaltolin over karka, correct? That's what the Tur says. That we have. Right?
Can I just ask?
Yeah, go ahead, please.
The whole difference between the Bach's approach and the Beis Yosef approach seems to be that the Bach underscores the Pasuk itself. because we have the pasuk that says Meitav Haaretz, so then that's why the Mazik can always say, I'm going to pay with Meitav, even though the Nizak is asking for Metaltalin. He says that might, you know, you might have had a case in Balchol, but because the pasuk itself says Meitav, so I'm going to pay with what the pasuk says. Is that what it's resting on?
Okay. I don't think exactly. I think what's resting on is this halacha that we have in Malvin Lova. Let me go through the cases here, okay? I made this chart. Okay. Because it's subtle, okay? But the first point is we're looking for a case where metaltalin is somehow a preference over karka. That you'll grant me, right? That's what he says. He says when the basin wants to collect, you collect from metaltalin first and then only karka. So we're looking for what case we're talking about. So here the Beis Yosef says, I tell you what case we're talking about. We're talking about, whoops, make it a little quieter. We can, okay. Okay.
Can you hear my kids in the background?
Though? Yeah. I love them. But...
You know what? I'm gonna mute my thing only when I'm not speaking. Okay. So.
Okay.
It might be a delay. When I say something, I'll have to unmute myself. Okay.
Okay. No, it's fine now. Now that they're not doing anything now. Okay.
No, but it's not predictable. So.
Okay. Whatever it is. Now, let's go. So the most important thing here is the key to focus on, that we're looking for a case in the tour where metaltalin is better than karka. Okay, that's what we're looking for. So the Beis Yosef says, I will tell you what case we're talking about. We're talking about where the mazik wants to give the nizak karka and the nizak wants metaltalin. That's the case we're talking about. In that case, the nizak can say, I want metaltalin over. Again, the mazik wants to give karka, and the nizak says, no, I don't want your karka, I want metaltalin. So we say, according to the Beis Yosef, the nizak has the upper hand. He can say to the mazik, I'm sorry, I don't want your karka, I want your metaltalin. Where does the tour get that from? He gets that from making an analogy between the case of Nezikin and in the case of Balchov. In Balchov, the person who is getting his money back has a right to say metaltalin is greater than karka, I want the metaltalin, and that's the same that we have in Nezikin. So that is now. Now, what about what's the alternative case? Okay, that the Beis Yosef didn't write about. What happens if the mazik wants to give metaltalin and the nizak wants karka? So there, the Beis Yosef would say also, of course, he has to accept the metaltalin, because the metaltalin is a better form of repayment than karka. You only have the right as a nizak to get a better form, but not a lesser form. Okay, so that's what the Beis Yosef would hold. Now, the Bach, well, I put him here, but let's look at the Bach. The Bach says that the stated case in the Shulchan Aruch is what the Beis Yosef, that was the Beis Yosef's unstated case. That's why I said the Aleph and Bet are reversed here. The Bach said, no. The Beis Yosef, why, in what case is the tour say metaltalin is greater than karka? That's when the mazik wants to give metaltalin and the nizak says, wait a minute, it says Meitav Sadeyu, I demand karka. In that case, the Bach will say, that's what the tour is talking about, you give metaltalin. So the Beis Din is going to his metaltalin because the nizak wants karka, and the din is with the mazik. Okay. Now, what would be the other case? So where the Mazik wants Karka and the Nizak wants Metaltalin, which was what the Beis Yosef held the Torah was talking about, and the Bach said he's not talking about that case at all. Right? So there, the Bach would say, of course you have to accept Karka. If the Mazik wants to give Karka, he has a right to give Karka, because Karka and Metaltalin are equal. So if we analyze this, we have to talk, you should unmute your thing. If we analyze this, it really will come down to that the Bach wants to place the Tor into our standard Rev Papa. And how does he do that? By saying that the Tor is only explaining the Gemara. You might have thought that since the simple pasuk says Metav Sadeo Metav Karmo, the Nizak can claim Metav Sadeo Metav Karmo, and the answer is no, they're totally equal. So if the Mazik wants to give Metaltalin, he can give it. All right. So that is the two basic explanations of the Tor. All right, maybe unmute yourself. I just want to.
Yeah. Okay. I'm unmuted now.
Yeah, because I want you to think. I mean, this was not so simple to put together.
Yeah, I didn't quite get it. I mean.
Yeah, I know. I understand.
I don't see the move to him. Okay, maybe we go through it again. Because I don't see why the Mazik is allowed to give Karka. It's according to the Bach.
Okay. Well, look, before the Beis Yosef made his revolutionary statement, we thought the Lacha was like Reb Papa, which means the Mazik can give Metaltalin or Karka or Kesef, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. That's what we thought. So the Bach is continuing in that vein. And he's saying, That's exactly what the.
Sorry,
go ahead.
I just wanted to see if I can get my tips to better.
All right. Okay.
It's late. Can you? It's 9:30. Can you go brush your teeth now? If you're ready for bed. Well, you can read for a while in bed. Yeah. At least it's only 9:30. 9:30 is pretty late. Oh, you can. At least, you know what? Play in your room. My room, because I can't hear it here. Because I won't be able to plug it in. Actually, maybe I can. No.
Okay.
You can hear me now, yeah?
Yeah, I can hear you. Okay, this is Baruch Hashem.
Muhammad goes to the mountain here.
All right, no problem.
Okay. Summertime, I can't say it.
No, I understand. My wife's listening to Rabbi Miller in the next room. I had to tell her to make things lower. Okay, but we need. No, it requires a lot of concentration here. What we're doing.
Yeah, it does.
Okay, this is not at all simple. Okay, let's look at the Bach. The Bach is going to say what the Tor said. Now I'm going to make it even simpler without this chart. Okay, here's the words of the Tor. Okay, and I superimposed the explanation of the Bach in the words of the Tor. Okay, so let's read that. Keshebain Ligvos Lenizak Nisko, Ronim Yesh Lamazik Metaltalin. We see if the Mazik has Metaltalin. If he does, Ein Yordin Lenichsav, Limkor Karkasav, and I Harotzon Shalanizak. That's the Chiddush. The Nizak's claiming, wait a minute, I read the Chumash every week. It says Metav Sadeh, Metav Karmo. You owe me Metav Karmo. So the Tor is saying, gentlemen, we don't do those things because we have Reb Papa, who said that you can give Metaltalin just equally to Karka. You with me? Eliyiten Metaltalin lefia rutzon shel hamazik. What do? We don't listen to the Nizak who went to shul and Ikris HaTorah says, Metav Sadeh, Metav Karmo. We said, you have to learn the Gemara. The Gemara says he can give you Metaltalin. Okay, so this
Right. Yeah.
this Bach is pure Rev Papa. Okay, how did he do it? We'll discuss that in a second. But this is what he did. He took the case where Karka was better than, excuse me, Metalfon was better than Karka, and he said the tour is only explaining that the principle that Metalfon is better than Karka, and therefore the Nisek has no claim it.
Right.
That's all. So he's telling us what in other words, the context that that the Torah is talking about is the Pesukim. Why would you think, here's a big, by the way, a very big chiddush in methodology of learning. Okay. What it's called, stating the opposite. Okay. So here, for instance, the Torah is saying you collect Metalfon before Karka. What would be the opposite of that?
Like Karka before Metalfon.
Correct. Now you say to yourself, and why would you think that you should collect Karka before Metalfon?
Because the Pasuk says so.
Exactly. Right? Now I'll also add, Rav Huna also says so, by the way. It wasn't only the Pasuk. So if the person was a little bit, the person was a little bit, learned a little Gemara too, he says also Rav Huna says that Kesem and Karka is better than Metalfon. So, but we don't hold like Rav Huna, do we? Right? We hold like Rav Papa. And that's exactly, in other words, we just gave two reasons why you would have thought that Karka is better than Metalfon. First, it says in the Pasuk. And second of all, Rav Huna also says Karka is better than Metalfon. So the Torah has to explain to us, says the Bach, that it's not better than Metalfon, because we hold Rav Papa, and Rav Papa holds they're totally equal. And that's how the Tur explained Peshat, excuse me, that's how the Bach explained Peshat in the Tur.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, if we take the same words, we take the same words, and we look what the Beis Yosef did, here's the Torah, and this is how the Beis Yosef interpreted the Torah. Keshebayim lahagvot lenizak nisko, ro'nim yesh lemazik metalfalin. Okay. Then, ein yordin lenik nisav limkor kakasav lefi ha-ratzon shel ha-mazik.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, is that right? Ein yordin lenik nisav limkor kakasav lefi ha-ratzon shel Mazik Ella Kafinin Ha Mazik Yi Ten Metalfon Kafi Harasan Shalanizak. So he's learning this Ein Yordan Limkor Karkasav is what the Mazik wants to do. The Mazik, he wants to say, hey, I want to give you my karka. Right? And the Nizak says, no, I want my Metalfon. And he says, the Beis Yosef, that's what he means, that the Nizak wins. It's not very clear in the Torah, by the way. I mean, I think that I think the Bach is a clearer reading of the Torah in a certain way.
The Bach is.
Yeah. I put the
Well, it doesn't, even with the insertions here, it doesn't quite, the rhetoric of it, I don't mean rhetoric in a bad sense. I mean,
Yeah.
if you say, Ein Yordan Onechsav, as if there's some type of stressful, we don't want to stress this guy out by going into his property. So
Yeah.
why would it be Lefi Ratzon Shel Mazik? See what I'm saying? Like it's Yordan Lenechsos is
Just
not
give me
just what it
1 second. I just want to put those two texts together, and then I oops.
Yeah.
Ugh, too much, too much, too much, too much, too much, too much, too much. Okay, let's go here and just get the Bach. Let's. Oh yeah. It wasn't focused. I don't know why. All the links. I have so many different documents now. What do I do here? Here's the Beis Yosef, and let me get the Bach. Okay, now we'll have the text together. Oops, I did it again. Here's the Beis Yosef, and then I'll get the Bach down here, and we'll discuss now the, okay, there we go. So now, both of them is not what we thought when we first glanced at the Torah, what the literal meaning was. I mean, what we thought the literal meaning was that the mazik cannot pay with karka. Or you thought you were trying to protect the karka, right, of the mazik? That's what you were saying, right?
Yeah.
You said
that's what I get out of just out of the language of ein or im.
Right. You say ein yordan limselim kor karkasav eli yiten metalton. Right. In other words, you're not, and so that's a simple. If the words are written out of context, you know, and what do I mean out of context? Without the background information of the Chumash and the Mishnah and the Gemaras and everything out and all the, you know, Rishonim, you know, you'd say somehow where, and by the way, people later on may try to explain the Torah like that. But it's interesting that neither the Beis Yosef or the Bach won't explain the Gemara in that sense. Why? Because they're trying to link the Torah with the Gemara. And we don't see any Gemara that says that we have to protect the Mazik's property. The only Gemaras we have talk about, Rav Huna puts Karka first, right? He's not protecting the Mazik's property. He says that's equal to Kesev and Suman's second. And Rav Papa is talking about what's closer to Kesev. He's not really concerned about, you know, what the Mazik wants to hold on to his property like, right? So what a very important lesson here is to understand that these people, the Beis Yosef and the Tur, are saying that Beis Yosef and the Bach are saying that the Tur is following the Masari. He's just giving over what the conclusions are. But he's not coming up with a new idea. It has to be founded on the Gemara. Where it is and who it is, okay, but it has to be founded on the Gemara. And we don't see the Gemara concerned with protecting the Mazik's property. I mean, his physical property, is right? So that's why I think they reject the simple meaning of the words, because if you take the words out of context, then you remember, you know, all these people, I believe, and they say, I read, they said to the Rambam, they want to quote the Rambam saying this, what happens is like this, you know, obviously the Talmud is an ocean. It really is an ocean. There's so many halachas, you know, 613 mitzvahs with all the details. So there's a need to categorize the information, to hold on to it, right? Because you just don't want to memorize the whole Gemara. I mean, I'm sure that there were people that definitely did do that. And there are people today that have done that. But you, even if you memorize everything, we see that the Gemara is interacting. Different pages of Gemara, different cases are interacting with each other, like we see that the Beis Yosef wants to say with the Balchol and the Nizak. So what you want to do is to summarize the halacha. Okay, you want to sort of strip away the debate and say, okay, now we have to write a book of conclusions. That's what the Rif started doing. I mean, that's what he did do, right? And then after him, the Rambam went whole hog, and now the tour is just limiting his summarizations. But they all really want to, you know, not leave, well, he says this, and he says this, and he says this. They want to bring it to a conclusion, okay? And of course, following the rules of how you come to conclusions, i.e., if the Gemara rejects opinions, you're not going to say that that's the conclusion, okay? Or if we have these rules of Bas-Roy, we're going to say, well, that can't be the conclusion, okay? So what they're all trying to do is summarize the halacha they're learning. Now, when you do that, you're doing that within the context of the Gemara. You're not just writing a new book as if when I'm going to start a new book now, just listen to me, You're doing that because you've read what the Gemara said, and now you're summarizing it and categorizing it. Okay, that's fine. So I think that's why this is the important lesson that we're learning here now. The Torah has to be based in the Gemara, and therefore we can't create a law like you wanted to say simply with Trey, look, it looks like we're trying to protect the property of the Mocher here. Well, that would be very nice, but that has no source in the Gemara. Okay, so I think go ahead.
Isn't it what, I don't want to take this protection idea too far, but isn't that what in the lower portion here, what the Bach's reading is of the Torah?
No, the Bach. Why? Why don't you go to his neches? Why?
Lefi ratzon shel mazik. The mazik wants to give metaltalin, and we don't take away his land according to what the Nizak wants.
Why? Because Reb Papa said that metaltalin is better than land. You have no right to land.
Okay.
It's Reb Papa. So you're
what does that mean? You have no right.
Excuse me?
I mean, what if he just, if the Nizak says, I want land, even though I know it's worse than metaltalin, so why can't we just give him land? I mean, why is that excluded?
Where do you see that the Nizak has any say in this matter? The Torah tells, why should, and in Svara, why should he be able to get something worse than what he's getting? In other words, if the Mazik wants to give him a talta, says, no, I want your karka. Is that the case you're talking about? Again, let's get the case right.
Yeah.
The Mazik says, I want to give you a metaltalin. He said, I want karka. So I say, look, what right do you have as a Nizak to demand karka? You have no right. As long as the Torah tells me what is considered acceptable. And since metaltalin is acceptable, I can give it to you. You're a simple person. You read Chumash, or you read even Rav Huna, so you want to say that karka is better? No, not at all. We hold like Reb Papa, and Reb Papa said that metaltalin is better. So you have no, you can't, if I want to give you metaltalin, you have no right to say, I want karka. Well, who are you to say that? Where are you getting that power to say that? Did I give you, you marry a woman with a ring, it has to be worth a shava pruta. If it's not, it says you can marry a woman with kesef or shava kesef. So, wait a minute, you gave me a ring, you didn't give me money. I'm not married? No. But if you give her half a ring that's worth less than a pruta, it's a piece of plastic, okay, and she accepts it, there's no marriage. So the same thing here. The mazik says, look, I have to pay you back. The Torah says I can pay you back with land, metaltalin, or kesef. And I decide what to give you. In other words, the Torah says all three of them are equal. So when you as a simple person, read the pasuk and you said, no, I can demand moedia, the Torah, that's not peshat in the pasuk. Reb Papa switched the tables to say that land is even less desirable than metaltalin, and it was a chiddush to say that it could even be used. But to give you metaltalin, no problem. You can't demand anything else. I'm giving the woman her money. I'm giving you what? I'm fulfilling my obligation. You have no right.
You have no right to ask for
land.
Less, you mean? Or
Yes, for less. Where do you get a right to ask for less? I decide what is more. I the Torah, whatever gives less. Where's your demand to give less?
Just simple logic in that. What does that mean? Like, I hear what you're saying, but I don't get to the common sense of that. Somebody says, "I want less," and you say, "Look, I don't have to give." Like, it doesn't make sense. I don't have to give you less. You see what I'm saying? Like, that's what I mean by the rhetoric of the language. Even when it falls through, "Afilu sheyesh lo kesef, yachal l'shalmo b'suvin," I'd imply that it's all about a certain, I don't know how to put it here. Like, there's an interest here, right? Somebody's interest is being looked after. He says, "Afilu yesh lo kesef," even though he has money, "yachol l'shalom b'suvin," so
The
that means
mazik,
he can,
the
yeah,
mazik, the
the mazik,
mazik,
yeah.
the mazik. Even if he has kesev, yeah, go ahead. He can even pay with subin.
So the mazik's interests are at stake here, right? And that's why the previous sections, I mean, line there, "Ein yordan l'nechshol mechol kakal." So you would think that the mazik interests are also at stake here. I think you're agreeing with that part. The one part I'm not getting the way you're saying that, like even following the grade which you've inserted, which you're saying is the Bach's reading here, right? From the Sefer, the fi haratzon shel hanizak. We're not going to go according to the ratzon of the nizak. We're looking up to the interests of the mazik in this case. So I don't get how could it be in against the interest of the mazik to ask him to pay less than what he owes? Like, isn't that just a contradiction, a simple contradiction? You see, I'm only, it's like a comedy routine. I'm
Well,
only giving you half.
because isn't less relative less? Sometimes the mazik may want to give karka, and he can if he wants to.
But he can't be forced to.
He can't be forced. Maybe he wants to hold on to this metalpolin or his cash. He just has to get rid of his land. Anyway, here, excuse me, he wants to hold on to his metalpolin. Excuse me, that's not true.
His no, his
Elitelamatal. He
land.
wants to hold on to his land. Even though it may be less kessable, less convertible, but he wants it.
He
Again,
wants what?
he wants to hold on to his metalto. Well,
The
excuse me.
mask.
No, that's not true. Let's go again. Ain yordan. He wants to hold on to his land. People like to hold on to their land.
Right,
Right?
right.
He wants to hold on to his land. The Mazik says, "No, I want your land," because it says Meita. He says, "No,
Right.
I have a choice to give you metalta, because metalta is even better than land. So now you want worse, but the question is, what does the Torah demand of me? The Torah demands of me to pay you with things which are closest to kesef. I'm paying you metalta. You have what are you going to say to me? Well, I want land. Well, where's your right to get land?
Okay.
I don't want to give you the land. You want the land. I don't want to give it to you. It's somehow considered less. Only in the bechina of convertibility is it considered less, but not in the bechina of what I desire. The Mazik says, "What I desire, I desire. I don't want to convert my land into money. I want to hold on to my land and make, cherries and apples and potatoes."
Okay, good. So can we go now? How do you understand? How to read the Beis Yosef reading of this? Because that part I did understand. That's the Bach's reading.
Yeah, that's the box reading. That's what we just
Yeah,
did.
the Bach's reading makes sense. Yeah.
So the box reading makes, I think it makes sense. I mean,
Yeah, it does make sense.
it's the Beis Yosef reading that's a little strange.
Right.
Let's go over the Beis Yosef again. Ein yodan limkor karkasav, lefi haratzon shel hamazik. The mazik now wants to hand over his land, right? I want to give you my land. Okay, I want to dump the thing which is, for some reason, whatever reason, I want to get rid of my land. What's the difference? Sometimes you like land better than Metatlin, sometimes you like Metatlin. So here he wants to dump his land. So the Nisak says, no, you can, I don't want your land, I want your Metatlin, and I have a right to it because it's close to Kesef. So the Mazik loses out. And Nisak can say, yeah, you know, we say to the Mazik, you know something? Nisak has a right to get that which is closer to Kesem, and he can demand your land.
He can demand your metaphorin. The Nisak can demand.
Excuse me, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Again, I'm on this thing right. I went too fast. And you know exactly. Well, let's go again. I want to say straight because I don't want to spin my head. The Mazik wants... the Mazik wants, according to the Beis Yosef, the Mazik wants to give land. No, I think I said it right. The Mazik wants to give land. Right?
Yes.
So the din is that if the Nizak wants Metaltalin, he wins. The Mazik must give him Metaltalin.
I just, it's a push on the terms Ein Yordin, right? I mean, it's logical, but it doesn't really make sense with Ein Yordin. I mean, because that really is a limitation on what can be done. So it reads a bit funny. So they don't force him to sell his land, which is what he wants to do.
You're right. It's very, very funny.
They don't force him to do what he wants to do, but rather it's weird.
But rather they force him to give Metalba. Exactly. I think you're exactly. It's a very, very odd reading of the tour. And not only is it a hard reading of the tour, it's not substantiated except by appealing to this case of Balchov, where the Malva has some power, and he's saying that we're importing it into this case. So it's not only a weaker reading, let's put it that way, or a dochek reading, pushed in reading, strained reading of the tour, but it's also appealing to a din that the Rush never said applied to Karka, and that the Beis Yosef is pushing in to it.
Okay.
Right? I mean, it's that's why the Bach is up in arms. Now this... Now this is going to be the as I said, the stage is set now for fights that are continuing, you know, down the generations here. You know, because again, the Beis Yosef is the Baal HaSod, he writes the Shulchan Aruch, he can write what he wants. So he's gonna write what he thinks the Torah said, you know, and then all the Chevra are gonna jump on him and say, come on, what are you doing? You know, I mean, you're just, you know, the question is, you know, why did he do it? Why did he do it? Why did he pick this interpretation? Mm-hmm. Why did he do it? When it has so many problems, even problems that he's very upfront, it does have problems, you know. Now, I think, again, people are going to discuss this, so we're going to get, you know, very heavily involved in it. But I think the Rambam is hanging around in the background somehow, and he understands. Maybe that's why he's pushing this in. But I really don't know. I mean, we're going to have to see. This is what's going to develop. We're going to, there's going to be people who are the defenders of the Beis Yosef, and the people are going to attack him. That's what's, it's just going to get, you know, it's just going to get more and more detailed. But that's basically, this is the stage for the next few hundred years. What do you have left? Another 600 years, something like that. This is basically the stage that's set here. Okay. Very, very interesting. Also, what's interesting is that we left this the Rabbeinu Tam and the whole Ashkenazic side of things. Okay, whether the tour, the tour is holding like the, if we hold like the Bach, then the tour is holding like the like his father, the Rush, and the Rush is holding like the Riff, and we're on the Svartic side of the Halacha, and it's never going to be seen again, Rabbeinu Tam. Usually the Rama, for instance, the Reb Moshe Isserles will come in and say, well, we don't hold such a thing because we side with Tosfos. So here he doesn't say that. Here he lets the din go, because we're going to see that there's also problems with Tosfos held, and two different Tosfos also thing. But it gets very exciting. So the people who are very serious about this are taking this setup of the Beis Yosef either to defend him and not. That's what's going on, and it's just going to keep, you know, battling back and forth with all sorts of proofs and interesting knockouts. But as far as the language is concerned, I think we can agree with the Bach. Now, both of them did not take the simple meaning that we explained, like you want to say protect the Mazik, and both of them didn't take the simple meaning that the Rama took, you know, which is that we just, the Mazik always, we always collect from the Mazik with Metatlin before Karka. That was how the Rama said it. So these people here on the page are not considering the Rama. Now later on we're going to have the Nachas David, he will bring the Rama into the picture. But right here we have rather marked distinction here. Okay, so let's go a little further and see some other people. Now they're going to line up either, you know, for him or against them, you know what I mean? So let's see what they say a little. Okay, but you see, this gets, I'm taking you into the depths of the stuff, you know what I mean? And that's the whole idea of this demonstration. I believe that a person should have at least one place where he goes from beginning to the end, so to speak. And then everything else, I mean, is just, they're doing the same thing. I mean, just, of course, with different cases and different arguments. But basically, this is what the Masara is. The Masara is, for instance, neither the Beis Yosef or the Bach want to say something against the Tor. The Tor is accepted as the halacha. You're always, by the way, in learning, you're always free to say what you want to say, but when it comes down to the practicality, so the halacha is what we follow. So no one's going to disagree with the Torah. The question is, what does he mean? Okay, so now I'm going to put you on the floor again. We're going to learn the Drisha. Okay, these are all people pretty much contemporaries we saw. Okay, let's see what he says. Oh, I even wrote here, he's going to say that the Yad Mazik is Al Yona. I put in gray, meaning that he's going to line up with the Bach. Let's see how he says it. Okay.
Se'if Tatap Yotet, Shabana Gavras Lanizak Nizkoi Churon.
No, Rizzi quotes them.
Yeah, wait, Baba Kama.
That's Baba Kama.
Zayin.
Right.
Right. Zayin. Romulia Bar, so this is the Rumia, right?
Right.
So Piresh Rashi.
Now, by the way, he says Ayin Bach, okay. Sheheviu. Okay. The Drisha says, look at the Bach. So now he's going to add something to the Bach. He's going to line up with the Bach against the Beis Yosef, but he's going to be a little more elaborate. Let's see what he does. So first he brings Rashi.
What does that mean?
Oh, now this, by the way, is a quote. This, by the way, is a
Yeah.
quote of none other than Rav Huna. This is Rashi when he spoke about Rav Huna. When Rav Huna came after this whole big interruption we had, the Mazik and the Nizak, he said, Omer Rav Huna, O Kesev, O Meitav. So Rashi said over there, what Rav Huna is doing is explaining how the two Pesukim of Meitav and Yoshiv go together. Bahachim Matarsekro. This is how Rav Huna is explaining the Pesukim. Okay. Bimitatlin.
Yashiv of Philosuban. Bimitatlin Yashiv of Philosuban.
If you want to give Mitatlin.
You can give even Bran.
Right.
But if you want to pay back with fields, you have to give Metov. Vishuv Garsinan Shandav Tet Zain Lament. What's the Girsa issue here? Garsinan is from Girsa, right?
Just 1 second. Oh boy. See that? Let's go back to Rashi. I think I made a mistake. I think that was the first part was Rav Papa. Let's go back. Baruch Hashem. Halachim Tarzei Kro. Okay. Just have a little piece here that's always in the way here. Let's go. Let's go Rashi. Here's Rashi. Here we go. Here's Rashi. No, I just want to look for those. I made a mistake. I think I made a mistake. Yes, that was my mistake. I'm sorry. On Dav Zion, when we ended up with Rev Papa, right, saying that kol mifuvchutz mi karka, right? This is Rashi's comment over there on Daf Zayin, because Karkam is Daben Mamasach. So he says, Ulahachi lo kasiv meitav elagabe sodos, vahachi mitatse kro, besodos yiten meitav, ubamitalton fil subens. You see, it was so important that we went back to Rashi. Let's go back again. Do you understand where we are geographically? This is the Rashi on Rav Papa, when Rav Papa made the distinction between Metaltalin and Karka. And Rashi said, I'll read it from the beginning. Kole, that's what Rav Papa said. What does that mean? Kol mile de Metaltalin shiyochol laholchen mimachem ze lamokom acher havi meitav. All types of Metaltalin, movable items that you can take from one place to another, that's called meitav. Why? De'i lo mizdaben hachi, he says, look, kule hai. You see, if you can't get all your money here, it's interesting, Rashi, then you can at least get all your money somewhere else. So you'll always get all your money back. Okay? But mizdaben, if you can't sell it here, kule hai, then you can do it in another place. And he says, Ulahachi lo kasav meitav ela sodos. And that's why it only said meitav gabi sodos. Why? Because metaplin is kulo meitav, because you'll always get your money back, your complete money back. Okay, you'll always transfer it. And then Rashi continues, and this, vahachi mitartse kro, and this is how we understand the pasukim now. Bis sodos, when it comes to a sodo, there you give metaplin. But when you're giving metaltalin, then a filu subin is okay. Because all, in other words, Rav Papa is telling us all metaltalin, the filu subin is okay, because you'll always get your money back. And when it comes to sodos, you give metav in order to inspire to make sure you get your money back by inspiring the local guys around. That's what Rashi says. Okay? Now, over on test, so that's what, I'm sorry, that was a very important correction. So the Drisha first brings Rashi, and he says, Rashi there on Zion, I should have put it there, he says, Bahachim mitatzei kro, and Yashiv afilu subin, and with sodas you give meitav, right? And then he says, quote number two, Vishuv gar sinan, there's on tet, right? Again, he explains, Garcina, I think he just means to, he writes, I don't know why he says Garcina, but that what? Rev Huna Omer, O Kesev Ometav. Ve'ilesle Yashiv Afilu Subin. In Rav Huna said you can, must give Kesev Karka, and if you don't have, then you give the Yashiv Afilu Subin. Ve'eno Yochel Lomar Lamazik, the Nizak can't say to the Mazik, Torach Umocher Va'aisei Zuz. What's the chiddush over there with Subin? That the Nizak can't tell the Mazik, hey, wait a minute, you go run around and sell the Subin and give me the money. Okay? So he just quoted Rashi in two places. We don't know what he wants yet. Okay? But that's what he did. But that's what he did. Mm-hmm. Let's see right there now. So what he's doing is he's bringing, again, from the halacha, you have to link the halacha back to our sources in the Gemara. Okay? And that's what they're doing. But depending on how you learn those sources, you'll come out to different halacha. So that's what the learning system here is about. Okay. Because of a Tosus for Rashi, go ahead, continue. That's point one. So what did he gain here with Rashi? Yeah. The two pasukim we solved by saying metaltalin, you can give anything, even suin, because that's all meta. But with sawdust, you have to give the meta of the field. That's all you can give. Okay, Kosovo Tosfos, continue.
Kosovo Tosfos or Rosh Beshemarif, the Lacha Kerepapa,
the Svarale?
The Svarale, the Metaltale made of Mikri. So the Tosfos and the Rosh in the name of the Rift say that the Halacha is like Kerepapa. Who explains?
Oh, I have to read that carefully. Yeah. Actually, I read it away first the first time too. But actually, Tosfos, both Tosfos and the Rush, in the name of the Rif, say that the halacha is like Repapa. Okay. Yeah. What Tosfos for Rush b'shem haRif? In other words, they both commented, as far as the Rif was concerned, the halacha is like Repapa, which we. Okay. All right, and what's the halacha? That all forms of metalton are called metav, okay? And then further, v'dayak harosh, oops, I'll just move it up a little.
The rosh is more
exact
on this point. The afilu isle kesef hakarka, even if he doesn't have.
No, is money, yes. Is yes, he does. The shin, the tuff is a shin. So, even if he does have kesev or karka.
Karka. Or shus biado liten lo afilu subin. He's within his rights to pay with subin.
Right. So, again, this is because we've done the sources. This is a summarization. And he's saying, of course, you know, both the Rush and Tosfos hold that the Rif holds like Reb Papa. And the Rush, he says, is Medayak even more, that even if the Mazik has Kesev or Karka, he can give Subin. Which is what was Reb Papa's position, right? That's how we always learned the Rush. They're all three equal alternatives, okay? Hari Rishut Biado Afilu Subin Vizel Ashino. Now he's going to quote the Rush. I want to read this quickly because he's just going to quote the Rush. Telekaman Amrina and Omale Rav Kahana La Rav. How do we know that Kesev and how do we know that Subin is equal to Kesev and Karka? How do we know? He brought a raya from Rev Kahana. That okay, and here it is. L'kamen omer la Rev Kahana l'Rav. Ela time the Kasiv Rachmanav Amaclo. Why did the Torah write Amaclo? Holav Hamamina Nevela the Mazik Have. What this alternative position was what the Vahamesi Lo tells the Nizak gets the novella, right? So Rav Kahana says, wait a minute, you need this Pasuk HaMesi Lo to take the, don't tell me that the Nizak gets the karka. It doesn't make sense. I'll show you why. Because if I didn't have the Pasuk according to you, right, you would have said that the Mazik gets the karka. How do I know? Because it says Yashuv L'Rab Shavik Kesev, right? So wait a minute. Since it says Yashuv L'Rab Shavik Kesev, Hashu the Islay L'Didei, if the Mazik has his own stuff, he can give it to the Nizak because it says Yashuv. Nevela that of the Nizak that bounces back to him, certainly he could give it. So that's what Rav Kahana said. Rav Kahana said the Pasuk Vahamesi Elo does not have to tell me that the Nizak gets the carcass. That I'll know even without that Pasuk. Why? Because since the Pasuk says that Yoshiv, that means the Mazik can re-give even Shavu Kesev, so he can give his own carcass that he has lying around the place. So certainly he can give the carcass that he's getting from the Nizak. So it's obvious that the Mazik can give the carcass. So I don't need a pasuk to mechadish that. So he says, V'i isa de Rav Huna, but if the halach was the Rav Huna, Rav Kahana couldn't have said that because lema de isterik kro, the islay kesef ometav. But if, this was the Rush's knockout of Rabbeinu Tam, if it's true that the halacha was like Rav Huna, that you can give kesef and metav, and you must give kesef and metav before metalphalin, if that was true, then I would need the kesef that says v'hamesi elo, to tell me that it goes to the Nizak, because if he has Kesev and Metav, then if he gets the carcass from the Nizak, he can't bounce it back to the Nizak, right? Because he has to give Kesev or Metav. So I need the Chiddush of the Pasuk to tell me that, no, even if he has Kesev or Metav, he can, the Nizak gets the Nevela, okay? So anyway, that was that Raya from Rav Kahana. But what the Bach wants to bring, not the Bach, what the Drisha here wants to explain is that according to the Rush, there's no question that Rev Papa is holding that you can give Subin equally to Kesev or to Metav. There's no question about it. You have the right to give it, and the Raya was from the way he brought Rev Kahana. And he says, Visham lifneze Kesev Rush Zal, call Shemutal, the Rush said clearly, call Shemutal alav lefroa, anything that falls upon him to pay, ben nezikin, ben balchov, porei lefi dato, velo lefi das hagoveya. The Rush makes the statement, unlike what we just learned in the Torah, that whenever you have to pay back money, whether it's nezikin or balchov, you pay according to the das of the lefi, porei lefi dato, the das of the mazik, and not lefi, the das of the person who is collecting. You always pay according to the person who is giving the money away or giving the money back, not the person who is collecting. So the Rus says clearly, and he says, kagon, im yesh kamakarko shekulam idis, yiten lo eza shiirtses, that like if he has a few pieces of land, they're all itis, then the mazik has the deciding hand. V'chein im omar ha-nizak, oh, v'chein im omar ha-nizak, tenli beinanis, say the nizak says, I want beinanis, that's, and the mazik omar says, no, I don't want to give it to you, because it's chaviva alai. You see, that answers your question too. Sometimes the mazik doesn't want to give the worst, because he needs it, it's important to him for some reason, you know. Ain kofen a soliten, says the Rosh. The Nizak can't force the Mazik to give. Okay? So here the Rosh, the Drisha, is quoting the Rosh and saying the Rosh is very, very clear that the Nizak has no rights. Whatever the Mazik wants to give, that's what the Nizak gets. as long as it's meta, but the meta va'aretz. But as far as any demand of the nizak, no way, says the drisha, and he just elaborates that this is clearly what the Rush says, clearly. And no one's arguing that. The Torah says, excuse me, the Beis Yosef says the Torah went away from his father and he added this new chop, that this new combination. But the Rush himself, it's clear that when the Zikin, the Nizek has no power. Okay? And he explains, and don't think by lessening the Nizek's power, Lo shayach lameh b'zeh horas kochan shel nizak and etzel beininis. This is a comment we had before. Don't think that, wait a minute, if you don't let the Nizak get Beninus, then aren't you hurting the Nizak? And the whole pusik of Meitav was supposed to help the Nizak? He says that's not so, because the Torah says, why? The lohar kochotve minayhu desham, shelo yochel litos meidis el idis. Giving, just like you can't move from it is to Beinus is not a taking away too much from the Nisak. Okay, Beseda. So the Drisha, after he brings the Rashi and the Rush, he says, Ula olam ein kofen l'mishalam liten minichasei elamash libo chotz. I'm sorry, that's the end of the Rush. Ula olam ein kofen l'mishalam liten min, excuse me, Ula olam ein kofen Lishalem, liten minichasei. The nizak can never force the mazik to give any of his property. Elamash libas, what the mazik wants, ubilvad shelo yivchas mi din. As long as he doesn't give him less than the din is meitav aretz. He has to give him. So I mean, if the nizak happens to, they both agree, they can agree what they want to do. But the nizak has absolutely no force. Ella, and he concludes, Ella Shim Yirtse, Liten La Yukra de Kame, Tzarech Liten Kedahashta. Okay, he adds that din, that also the din is with the Nizak as far as the present price and not the future price. Okay, so this is all the Drisha quoting the Rush, and we did the groundwork there in the Rush, so it's familiar to us. Vinilma me Mashikatuv Shabiad Hamazik. Now, the tour, this now is a Drisha. Vanilmat, I add the word. Vanilmat had told me, my shir, the Habrer b'yad hamazik. Since his father, the Rush, clearly said the choice is in the hands of the mazik. The imiyesh b'yado kesev o idis, if the mazik has kesev or idis karka, harushut b'yado liten lo shava kesev afil subin. He has complete rights to give subin. Just like the Rush said. Okay, so he's saying that the there's no way the tour would be disagreeing with the Rush, and the Rush said this clearly. And why should he disagree with his father? So you basically are just inventing a peshat here, which has nothing to do with the tour, because the tour is just doing what his father's saying. He's just writing it, you know. Umishum degamhu nikra meitav shuspiado liten me'eza meitav shiirtza, says the Drisha. And since Subin and Kark are equally considered meitav, so he can give either one. Umine the im ha-nizak chofetz v'metaltolin, if the nizak, let's go slowly here, wants metaltolin, v'hamazik eino rotze litnam, and the mazik doesn't want to give him the metaltolin, lo. The im idish shebekarkasav, no, the mazik says, no, I don't want to give you the metaltolin, I want to give you the idish, shahadin im ha-mazik. The mazik wins, no matter what case it is, whether the mazik wants to give metaltolin and the nizak wants kark, or the mazik wants to give kark and the nizak wants metaltolin, says the Drisha. It's clear that the mazik always has the upper hand. Va'af ha-rush kasav, belova umalva shafal pishagam halova dato malamikol makam imrotze hamalva metaltalin hadini mo kamosh kasuba simin kufe. Ah, it's true that the Rush, when it came to the malva and the lova, he said the lova who is like the malva who is like the lova in our case, excuse me, the Malva was like the Nizak in that case, so the Malva has a right to demand Metaltalin over Karka. He did say that. But Shani Malva Valova, but the case of Malva and Lova is totally different than the Zikin. It's Shani Malva Valova Lo Kesev. Shumahacha Dino Lichat Chila. Excuse me. Deshane Shemalva Halova Lo Kesev. Vishane comma. That case of Malva and Lova is totally different than the Zikin. Why? Because the Malva gave the Lova Kesev. So there, the Malva has some sort of say in the situation. Mishum hachi dinu lichatchila Kesev, o dom le Kesev, the hainu shava Kesev. So that's why in the case of the Malva getting his money back, he can demand money or its equivalent, which is shava Kesev. And he can say, I don't want to take your karka if you want to give it to me. Masha ain came in the Zikin. That in the Zikin, the rush would never hold strings. The din ol chatchila filu subin, because in the Zikin, the din is a filu chatchila you can give subin. Af sheyesh lo kesev oedis, even if you have kesev oedis. V'kala havini says, and he says v'harachti b'zek kedei lafukim mamash k'tuva beis Yosef. The reason why I spelt all this out is because I want to tell you this is the opposite of what the Beis Yosef said here. Al Divrei Rebbe on the tour, Ayin Sham. Vani Omer, and look at what the Beis Yosef said. Vani Omer me olam lo alasa al das Rebbe, who's the tour lahavatan bezer. I don't know what lahavatan means. I should look it up. Elamire kashamazik rotzali ten lo metaltalin vanizek hofes itis ukumash tu beferish Ayin Sham. Okay, Viduk says, look into it. So again, the Drisha here is now adding, what did he add here? He says, he added all the places where the Rush clearly said, the Lacha is not only like Reb Papa, but Subin is equal to Metav and Karka. There's no distinction to be made. Okay, and all the cards are in the hand of the Mazik paying the back, Mazik. Right? And yes. You Beis Yosef have no. They're cutting the legs out of the Beis Yosef here. So you have no leg to stand on. So that's the second. That's the second one now. The Lavush, let's see. Although the Lavush is short, okay? But the Lavush now, excuse me, this is called Lavush Yeshoshan. Now, he wrote all his books had a name associated with Purim, okay? So this is called the Yeshoshan. Okay, now... Lavush Mordechai? Because his name is Mordechai. His name is Mordechai, so he wrote Levir Il Shoshan. He wrote all sorts of, because of Mordechai, all these names. Okay? So here he writes on Har Lacha, and here he is going to stand up and defend the Beis Yosef. Okay? So that's what I said. The stage now is set for this drag-out battle, which is going to go on for a few centuries here. This is not, you're going to be friends or foe here. You got to make up your mind here, because the halacha is going to be totally different. I mean, okay, let's see what he has to say. In Baba Kama, it says the following, Perek Aleph. Ketzad Nifroyen, this is, by the way, one second. Ketzad nefroyin l'nezikin mehazik u'miyor shav. How does the mazik pay back for his damage to the nizak and the nizak's relative? Ketzad nefroyin l'nezikin mehamazik. How do you pay back the nizak for the damage of the mazik, and also to take money from the Yerusha. What happens if the poor mazik dies by the time they settle this case in court? So then you're going to have to claim to the Yerusha, right? Kasev ben Ezekin, it says, Meitav Sadehu Meitav Karma Yishalem. The Pasuk says in the Torah, Meitav Sadehu Meitav Karma Yishalem. Umashma'us Pashte Dekro. And the simple understanding of this pasuk, mashma da eko mashama. That's how you pay. You pay with meitav sadeh or meitav karma. No, that's not that's what we want to say. Dahainu hamazik yishalmi meitav. Exactly. The mazik has to pay with meitav. No one will argue that that's not the pashto of the pasuk. The pasuk says meitav sadeh meitav shalom, and it means that the mazik has to pay with his, the best of his land. That's what it says. The kaven sheomra hatora letet lenizak mutav shebenichse hamazik, and since the Torah said that the nizak, the kaven sheomra hatora letet lenizak, and since the Torah said give to the nizak min hamutav shebenichse hamazik, the Torah wants the mazik to give the best of his property. Omru Chazal, the Eboy Hanizak Metatlin, Tzarech Hamazik Litenlo. I don't know where he's quoting this from. The Eboy Hanizak Metatlin, if the Nizak wants Metatlin, so the Mazik has to give it. Why? The Kol Mide de Makrafe Lezuze Tve. Because anything that's closer to money, he has to give. V'nichale l'nizak, kol mile, he says 2 points, kol mile makrave l'zuzei tvei, v'nichale nizak tzarech litenlo, v'hainu metaltalin. The metaltalin mutaf, I'm sorry, I'm not reading this right. Wow, this is a chiddush, and first of all, let's say he threw me where Omar Chazal, where did Chazal say? This is a whole... The first point is the Torah clearly says give meitav karka. That's the first point, right? And he learns that means you have to give the best of the mazik has to give the best of his property. So he says, Omru Chazal, I don't know where Omru Chazal said this. De'i boy ha-nizak metatlin, if the nizak wants metatlin, tzarech ha-mazik li-tenlo, the call Mide de makrefe le zuze tve, v'nichele le nizak, serech li ten lo. Everything that's closer to money and is also more desirable for the nizak, the mazik has to give. Why is it behind a metaltalin? I'm confused here. Go ahead.
From what I can gather, the whole argument seems to rely on this, on the his use of the word mutav, right? So he's taking meitav sadehu, and he's generalizing that point to say, look, okay, we're out to give the mazik, the nizak, sorry, a mutav, or whatever is mutav from the mazik, that's what we can give to the nizak. So it kind of sets a kind of a general obligation on the mazik, right?
Right.
So then he's, by the way, but Hayinu Metaltalin, really, Metaltalin is really Mutav. It's kind of a funny move to say.
Well, he says, the Eboy Hanizak Metaltalin, the Mazik has to give it. Why? Because, why does he have to give it? Because it's closer to money and he wants it. What does that have to do with? So when it says Metav, the way he's learning, I think, is Metav Soda means you have to give the best of what he wants.
Yeah. That seems to be it. Well, that's what he says, behind metaltalin, the metaltalin meitav who, because that's where he brings it back into the lashon of the Gemara. That why do we say that metaltalin is meitav? Because really, we want to give what's mutav in general, as a general, very abstract category. You want to give what is meitav. So if we're giving what is best, so metaltalin falls into that general category. In fact, more easily than karka. Because nichalei lenizak, it's more convenient for the nizak. So in a sense, it's the best of the that belongs to the mazik. He's making a couple of jumps very quickly here, though. He's not really explaining his moves.
And it's all in Svara, right?
Yeah.
So let's go over it again. It says, the Torah says, give Meitav Sadehu, right? Right? Umashvas Peshitta Dekro Mashvada Eichko Shalim. You have to pay the best. The Hainu Hamazik Yishalmi Meitav Sadehu Shadeshto. I mean, the simple thing, that's what threw me. The simple thing is that he has to give the best of his field. V'kev Mishoma HaTorah L'tet L'nizak Mina Mutav Sheminich Se Hamazik. And since the Torah said, this is the move, right?
This is the move.
He generalizes it.
Yeah, by using the word nechse, he's taking it away from karka.
Right.
He said meitav sadehu. But now he's saying, ah, meitav sadehu is really short form for meitav nechse amazik in general.
And since Vitalvan is meitav nechse amazik, he can take it too. It's even better. So the Torah, when it says Meitav Sadehu, but look what he's doing here. This is Gavala, right? This is some way to save the Beis Yosef, right? He has to darshan the Pesukim to say, when it said Meitav Sadehu, it was saying that he has to give the best of his property. So, of course, Metaltalin is better than land. So, of course, if the Nizak wants it, he's going to get it because that's the whole spirit of the law. That's pretty exciting. Yeah.
But then he brings in Rapapa's reasoning at the end to justify it, right?
Yeah, exactly. Just to show that that's more Meitav than Meitav.
Exactly. Yeah. Right.
The Torah said you have to give the best that you have. So, of course, the best of the best you certainly have to give. But it's talking about what you have to give to the, exactly. So what you have to give to Nizak, you have to give him the best. So certainly the best of the best you have to give. If Nizak wants it. Very, that's what he says. I can't argue with him. I'll let you read. Oh boy. I'll let you read. Lefikach.
This is still the...
Yeah, here I wrote the Torah, and I wrote the Rambam just to have it next to us, but it's okay. We know both of them. So, Lefikach, this is the Drish again. Lefikach.
Lefikach, Shabbaton is cocking the Hagvois, Lenizak, Menech, Nesei, Hamazik, Rain. So, when the Bezdin force for the mazik, I guess, to pay to the nizak from the property of the mazik.
Yes, to collect. I think the correct language, Kesha, based in Niskachen, when they are obliged lahagvot to collect the nizak,
collect for the nizak,
from the property of
the property of the mazik.
Rowan.
So they look. In yesh lo metaltalin, en yod lenechsav. If he has movables, he don't go into his land, but he pays with movables. This is the same language.
Exactly. This is just a quote. Name low.
Right. So the im lo hayu lo metaltalin klal, or shelo hayu lo metaltalin keneged kol hanizak hanezek. If he doesn't have any movables at all, or he doesn't have enough to cover the cost of the damage, go in a sha'ar. So that's when we actually dip into the land, go into the land. Me'ula, I guess, is the best here. Me'ula.
Yeah, he added that, right?
He means the best from the property of the mazik.
Right.
Yeah, so. The Meitav Sadehu Ksiv. So again, because it says is Meitav Sadehu. He's focusing on the word Meitav here.
Right.
This Meitav is Mutav. Kol Zman Sheimatse Metaltalin Ve'afilu Subin. So long as we find movables and even bran, Ein is Kakin Lekarka. We don't force him to sell his land or to, we don't go into his land. Mihu. What does that mean? Does that mean that, however? No.
Yeah, Mew's however.
However, the metaltalin, the filu yeshla metaltalin shel kesef, when if with movable with movables and even what does that mean that he has movables that are made of silver or are equivalent to money? Or
I think that's money. I think he's holding that all metatlon is not only physical objects, but also money's metatlon because you can move it around.
Mm-hmm. He can nevertheless pay him with suvin. He doesn't have to.
Yeah, once it's metatlon. Yeah, go ahead.
Maybe he doesn't. I mean, I don't know if it could, maybe it does mean literally silver, kesef, in the sense of he doesn't have to melt down his kiddush cup, you know, to get paid with.
Yeah, but then there would be no kiddush by saying it.
The metaltami call mile metaku because everything that is metaltami.
Okay, now he's just really rereading lefikach. Now he's just reading like making a taich in the tour, right? So he just now that's not interesting. Now he just you know read the tour. But what's interesting here is he thought to save the Beis Yosef Gavalt.
Is he explicitly trying to save the Beis Yosef?
Yeah. But I don't understand, unless this is through me also. Baba Kama Aleph, Ketzad Nefroin LeNezikin MeHamazik MeYorshasav. I don't know who he's quoting. That's what threw me. I don't know who he's quoting here. I have to tell you the truth. I have to look into it again. I have to look at the original proof here, but it's very strange. But what he did here to save the Beis Yosef was to darshan the pasuk. That means you can make the sedeh means you have to give the best, and therefore, since Subin is called the best, you can demand it. Well, it doesn't prove anything what he said. He's just not really proving anything. He's just lining up with him. So I can't see too much excitement in that. Okay. Anyway, what I have to do next time we meet, that's a good time, and we can stop here. The next time, the next thing we're going to do is to go into the Shulchan Aruch. Now, these are the people that we, the people on the daf over there in the tours is the Rama who gives the Ashkenazim, the Lavush, the Drisha, and the Bach. Okay? Now, the Shulchan Aruch now is the Rama here at Darkei Moshe over there at the tour, and then he writes his amendations to the Shulchan Aruch, the Beis Yosef. Here he does not talk. Very interesting. But we're going to go into now two other commentaries, the Sma and the Shach. Okay, now they are going to be much more helpful in explaining the Shita of the, at least the Shach will explaining the Beis Yosef will be much more helpful, much more clear. He'll try to do it inside the text. Okay, so glean out of what I'll do. I'll send you the stuff, you know, you're welcome to look at it. But you see that what's happening now is now the battleground has been set here. What does the tour mean? And prove it. Okay? Right. Now, the Beis Yosef seems to be pretty beaten up at this point. Okay, he doesn't fit into the simple meanings of the text. He takes the rush and he tells us that even though the rush doesn't hold us, the tour made a cholentir and put together the balchov with the nizak, you know. So it seems that he's on the ropes at this point. So we're going to see the Sma is going to defend him the Shach is going to defend him with some powerful stuff. Okay, that's the next thing we'll do. And we got up to around 1600 now, Baruch Hashem. So we have another 400 years to go yet. But there's big stuff. Later on, it's very interesting that the early people wrote very briefly, and the later people write much more extensively. And the later they get, the more, like you'll see the Nachlas David, it's very interesting to see that's where we're doing it. The Nachlas David has, I don't know, something like 6 pages. And this Reb Meltzer, who's the last person I'm going to do, is a Rosh Hashiva of Etz Chaim here, and, you know, in the last generation, you know, also has, you know, many pages on this. So it's very interesting that they write and they elaborate and they explain much more what is actually happening behind the scenes. What we see is up to this point, if we had to, you know, give points, it looks like Beis Yosef is on the ropes. But as the course continues, we'll see more of the action there. Okay, so great. Have a great one, and Bezat Hashem, we'll meet again on when? What's your schedule? Sunday, Bezat Hashem.
Sunday night's good, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Bezat Hashem. Okay, be well. Have a great evening, and I'll try to send this to you, and you can look over it and get some reviews and whatever you'd like to do. You know, I'm sure you're very busy, but if you can look at it, of course, you see the stuff gets deeper and deeper and more subtle, so we have to get it. Okay.
I know. It's more subtle. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's the same material all the time, but it it comes more and more subtle.
No, I know, but it's a system. It's so, yeah, it's like an anatomy lesson. You have to, you know, to see the whole organism and all of its parts, and I lose track all the time.
Exactly. I mean, it's understandable to lose track. So, Blinetta, we'll get together. We'll keep. That's why I'm making all these charts and everything to keep us together. You know, and Bezat Hashem. I mean, once you get the basics, I mean, the Gemara is never going to change. You know, basically now, we're in the tour and we're trying to link up with. We have two sides here, Beis Yosef and the Bach, and you're either for him or against him, and we're going to have to, you know, see how people defend him, because not looking too good right now, but we have to wait till the end of the fight. And that's the luck is with him, by the way. Okay, be well, and have a great week, and a good Shabbos, and we'll see you on Sunday.
All right, good Shabbos.
Kol tov.